pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay, will the clerk please read the public hearing notice?
Public hearing for the annual modifications to Orange County Agricultural Districts Number 1 and 2 in accordance with New York State Agriculture and Markets Law, Section 303A. Notice is hereby given that the Orange County Legislature and members of the Department of Planning of the County of Orange, New York will meet at the auditorium of the Orange County Emergency Services Center located at Emergency Services Building, 22 Wells Farm Road, Goshen, New York, on the first day of July 2015, beginning at 6:45 p.m. for the purpose of holding a public hearing and to solicit comments and concerns from the public with respect to the proposed modifications on Agricultural Districts Number 1 and 2. Orange County Agricultural District Number 1 is located to the northeast of New York State Route 17 and encompasses all or parts of the towns of Blooming Grove, Chester, Cornwall, Crawford, Goshen, Hamptonburg, Monroe, Montgomery, Newburgh, New Windsor, Walk Hill, and Woodbury. Agricultural District Number 2 is located southwest of New York State Route 17 and encompasses all or part of the towns of Chester, Deer Park, Greenville, Goshen, Minnesick, Monroe, Mount Hope, Walk Hill, Warwick, and Wiwiana. Further notice is hereby given that copies of landowner applications and written recommendations of the Orange County Agricultural Farmland Protection Board environmental assessments and other related documents are on file with and may be examined in the office of the clerk of the county legislature at 15 Matthew Street, Suite 203, Goshen, New York. The Orange County Planning Department at 124 Main Street, Goshen, New York, and on the Orange County website at www.orangecountydevelop.com. The following landowners are requesting inclusion of parcels in the ag districts of Orange County. Town of Newburgh, section block and lot 14-148, and Lissa Halstead, Town of Walk Hill, section block and lot 31-126.1 and 31-127. This notice was published in the June 24th issues of the Hudson Valley Press, Walk Hill Valley and Mid-Hudson Times, the June 26th issues of the Sentinel, Warwick Advertiser, Monroe Photo News, the Chronicle News, the Highlands Pullman Local, and the Gazette.
Thank you. At this point, I'm going to open the public hearing. I ask that anyone who would like to speak, please sign up with the deputy clerk at the front of the stage. All speakers will have a 3-minute time limit. Okay, well, we have no speakers. I'm going to declare the public hearing closed. Thank you.
All cell phones and electronic devices, and would everyone please stand for a moment of silence and pledge of the flag. Yep. For a moment of silence for the passing of George Woolsey, Town of Newburgh, Deputy Supervisor. Thank you. Public participation. Oh, roll call first, I'm sorry.
Monasick?
Here.
Ekus?
Here.
Amel?
Here.
Anagnostakis?
Here.
Benton?
Here.
Berkman?
Here.
Benelli? Cheney?
Here.
Dillard? DeSalvo?
Present.
Fagione?
Here.
Hines?
Here.
Chemnitz?
Here.
Kulisek?
Here.
Padu?
Here.
Ruskevich?
Here.
Sullivan?
Here.
Turnbull?
Here.
Vero?
Here.
Wong?
Here.
Brescia?
Here.
19 ayes, 2 absent.
Okay, we have a proclamation for the Parks and Recreation Month. I invite Richard Rose up, Commissioner of Parks. On behalf of the county legislature, it gives me great pleasure to present you with this proclamation. Quite lengthy, and I'll read the first whereas and the last now therefore. Read the whole thing? Designation of of July as Park and Recreation Month. Whereas parks and recreation programs are an integral part of communities throughout this country, including Orange County, and now therefore be resolved by the County Executive and the Orange County Legislature that July is recognized as Parks and Recreation Month in the County of Orange. Congratulations, we have one of the finest park systems in the state of New York, if not the country. Congratulations.
Thank you. You all behind you have, which can, by the way, hang Steve in your office after tonight, a little poster reminding everybody that it's Parks and Rec Month. Just handing out to the legislature a quick map, just to remind everybody that not only do we have great county parks, but the county itself has a great park system, which is made up of local parks, state parks, county parks, and even a little bit of federal parkland out in the town of Warwick called the Appalachian Trail. About 24,000 acres of parkland, so we're very fortunate here in the county to have a great park system, and we encourage everybody in the month of July and every other month of the year to get out and use it. Thank you.
I'd like to congratulate a gentleman who's been with the county as long as I've been with the county, in many capacities, many leadership roles. Was with Joe Rampe, Eddie Diana through their tenures, served as commissioner of a few different departments, a very knowledgeable individual, very congenial individual, and recently he was elected second vice president of New York State Association of Personnel and Civil Service Officers. Goshen, New York, Orange County Commissioner of Human Resources, Stephen M. Gross, was unanimously elected on Monday to serve as the second vice president of the New York State Association of Personnel and Civil Service Officers, NYSAPCSO. I am honored to have been chosen by my peers across the state of New York to serve as the second vice president, however you say it, Gross said. The NYSAPCSO represents easy for me to say, NYSAPCSO represents 98 municipal civil service entities across the state and works to promote the best practices in education with respect to the administration of the civil service merit and fitness system. Mr. Gross' election to this important statewide position demonstrates that Orange County has some of the best departments in the state of New York, Orange County Executive Steve Newhouse said. I congratulate and commend Mr. Gross on his appointment as second vice president of the State Civil Service Association. Congratulations, Steve. Job well done. And we also know that you were the catalyst and one of the masterminds of this contract from the negotiation end that we're about to adopt tonight. Thank you for that very much.
Thank you, Chairman. Appreciate it.
I'd like to thank Savannah Shapiro, too, who's out in the audience, for your integral part in that contract negotiation, too. Thank you. Okay, Majority Leader Bonasek.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I move to approve the minutes of May 7, 2015.
Second.
Okay, are there any referrals, withdrawals, or consents?
Yep, Mr. Chairman. I just wanted to ask in number 7 that the town of Newburgh parcel 9350.11 be separated from the others.
Okay. There's no objections? Well, how many separate votes are we going to have? Let me just ask that.
Looks to me like it would be 3.
3? The two town of Newburghs are separate.
Correct.
And then the remainder.
Correct.
Good. Okay. Less confusing than I thought. We're going to do a town of Newburgh, a town of Newburgh, and then the rest, okay? There's 4? All right, when we get there, we'll play it by ear. Okay, nothing under public participation. We have one speaker signed up afterwards, right? Okay. I'd like to thank the other negotiating units from the negotiating team to Mr. Lopez, right, from the PBA. Anybody else here? Jeremy Yell, are you part of that, Jeremy? Hey, is he? My neighbor down the street. Okay, congratulations to you guys, and thank you. Okay, we're ready to start. Okay, AA and BB are receive and file. CC also? Okay. Resolution number one.
Legislator Sullivan and Wong, resolution authorizing the making of an agreement between the County of Orange and the County Employees Unit of the Orange County Chapter of the Civil Service Employees Association, Inc., in relation to the terms and conditions of employment pursuant to Article 14 of the Civil Service Law known as the Public Employees Fair Employment Act.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Bonison?
Yes.
Ickes?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Cheney? DeSalvo? Fagion? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Raskevich? Sullivan? Turnbull? Vero? Wong? Rescher? 19 ayes.
Okay, resolution number two.
Legislators Paduk and Sullivan, an act amending Act Number 22 of 1971 as last amended by Act Number 1 of 2009 by substituting new salary schedules therein applicable to all employees of the County of Orange who are included in the negotiating unit represented by the County Employees Unit of the Orange County Chapter of the Civil Service Employees Association.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Bonison?
Yes.
Ickes?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Cheney, DeSalvo, Fagion, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, Paduk, Raskevich, Sullivan, Turnbull, Vero, Wong, Rescher, 19 ayes.
Okay, number three.
Legislator Sullivan and Wong, an act amending Act Number 22 of 1971 and last amended by Act Number 2 of 2009 by inserting therein a new salary list for certain Orange County employees not included in the negotiating unit represented by the County Employees Unit of the Orange County Chapter of the CSEA.
Second.
Question? Legislator Perdue.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Just a point, in our caucus, we had a concern regarding this. These 30 employees are not covered by any union contract. However, for them to meet the same grade schedules as the, because that's what they basically go by. Once we have approved the contracts for PBA and for CSEA, these members, these 30-something people here, will be able to, at the same grade as the contracts that they have now. And our concern was there wasn't any listing in regards to what their grade was. So Commissioner Gross was kind enough to add it to this so that we know now there'll be no changing. Other, you know, it has to come back to the legislature for any grade title to be changed. However, we had a concern because it wasn't listed here that maybe by giving them the approval, there could have been a slip up or something where grade 12 was a grade 13. However, now I have it, and I'd like to just submit this to you, Antoinette, to make sure that these grade schedules are put in as they are here. Okay, thank you.
Okay, thank you. Legislator Burke.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I don't want to be repetitive, but I just wanted to thank Mr. Gross for straightening out what was a concern of mine and others in the caucus as to whether we were authorizing the change of grades, not the terms of the negotiation of the contract. That was not in question. We were okay with that. But I didn't want to inadvertently give permission to change grades of different jobs, and Mr. Gross assured me that that's definitely not the case, so it stays the same. Thank you.
That's an important concern. I'm sure we will all share that concern. So, any other comments? Okay, roll call.
Bonison?
Yes.
Ickes?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Cheney? Salvo? Fagion? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk, Raskevich, Sullivan, Turnbull, Vero, Wong, Gresham, 19 ayes.
Number four.
Legislators Cheney and Sullivan, resolution authorizing the acceptance of the proposed contract with the Orange County Deputy Sheriff's Police Benevolent Association.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Bonnison.
Yes.
Ekis.
Yes.
Amo.
Yes.
Anagnestakis. Benton. Erkman. Cheney. DeSalvo. Fagion. Hines. Kemnitz. Kulisek. Padu. Ruskovich. Sullivan. Turnbull. Vero. Wong. Gresham. 19 ayes.
Number five.
Legislators Padu and Sullivan, an act to establish a new salary schedule therein applicable to all employees of the County of Orange who are included in the negotiating unit represented by the Orange County Deputy Sheriff's Police Benevolent Association.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Bonnison.
Yes.
Ekis.
Yes.
Amo.
Yes.
Anagnestakis. Benton. Erkman. Cheney. DeSalvo. Fagion. Hines. Kemnitz. Kulisek. Padu. Ruskovich. Sullivan. Turnbull. Vero. Wong. Gresham. 19 ayes.
Okay, number six.
Legislator Wong, resolution create a voluntary separation agreement from Orange County employees. I'm sorry, for Orange County employees.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Bonnison.
Yes.
Ekis.
Yes.
Amo.
Yes.
Anagnestakis. Benton. Erkman. Cheney. DeSalvo. Fagion. Hines. Kemnitz. Kulisek. Padu. Ruskovich. Sullivan. Turnbull. Vero. Wong. Gresham. 19 ayes.
Okay, number seven, right? Yes.
I think I seconded it.
Yes, sir. Yes. Okay, number seven.
So, Mr. Benton, if you'd like to make your separate out on county number 9350.11 and 9350.12.
Yes. Is there a second?
Second.
All in favor? Opposed? Carried. Okay, which one are we going to start with?
Okay, we're on number seven, so you're going to go to the second page, Schedule A, and where it says John Huddleston and Carol Foley.
Can you grab a microphone, please?
Sure. Okay, on Schedule A, we're just going to remove at this point in time for purposes of voting, in Ag District Number 1, John Huddleston and Carol Foley Huddleston, Town of Newburgh, Section Block and Lot 9-350.11 and 9-3-50.12, 3 acres, and we will vote on all the other parcels set forth on Schedule A.
Okay, so. Okay, number seven. Okay, discussion? Roll call.
Go ahead.
Kevin, I'm sorry.
Yeah, just with respect to number seven, I just want to advise all the legislators, you all saw a letter from me indicating that with respect to the town of Cornwall property, I own 100% of one house, 600 feet from it, which I hold for rental property, another house where I own a percentage of it with the rest of my family, was also another 600 feet on the other side of this property. I sent a letter to the Board of Ethics, and the Board of Ethics indicated that I would have no problem voting on this. And I also felt that way, but the answer from the Board of Ethics was that I do not have a conflict with respect to the Cornwall property, so I will be voting on it.
Okay. Roll call.
Bonnison.
Yes.
Ekis.
Yes.
Amo.
Yes.
Anagnestakis. Benton. Erkman. Benelli. I'm sorry. Cheney. Salvo. Fagion. Hines. Kemnitz. Kulisek. Padu. Ruskovich. Sullivan. Turnbull, Vero, Wong, Gresham, 19 ayes.
Okay, now on section block and lot 9-3-50.11 and 0.12. Okay, discussion? Okay, yes, Kevin.
In committee, I abstained from the two Newburgh properties because my brother is an engineer with the engineering firm of McGowey, Hauser, and Edsel. I did check on the issue, and he is a consultant to the planning board in Newburgh and doesn't represent any of these landowners or anything of that nature. In consultation with legislative council, it was determined that I did not have a conflict on that either, so I'm okay to vote on that, I was told.
Okay. Roll call.
Bonnison.
Yes.
Ekis.
Yes.
Amo.
Yes. No.
Benton?
No.
Berkman?
Yes.
Cheney?
Yes.
DeSalvo?
Yes.
Fagio?
Yes.
Heinz?
Yes.
Kemmons?
Yes.
Bullock?
Yes.
Paduk?
Yes.
Riskevich?
Yes.
Sullivan?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Vero?
Yes.
Gresham?
Yes.
16 ayes, 3 noes.
Now which one? Number 8. Oh, this, were we separated in committee because Jeff asked? Okay, motion on these, or, okay.
Legislators Ekis, Dillard, Amo, Bullock. Resolution of the Orange County Legislature assuming lead agency status, taking the action as an unlisted action, and making a determination under the State Environmental Quality Review Act, SEQA, with respect to the inclusion of certain real property in Orange County Agricultural District Number 1 pursuant to New York State Agriculture and Markets Law, Section 303B.
Discussion? Yes, Minority Leader Ekis.
First of all, I'd like to thank those who put me as a sponsor, because I'm very proud to sponsor this resolution. I believe that as we vote on each one of these things, we're actually promoting small businesses throughout this county, and I've never heard a single legislator say, "I don't promote small business." So I'm, again, I'm very pleased, and I want to thank those that were responsible for making me sponsor this.
Legislator Berkman.
Just highlighting that this is not an authorizing resolution, this is a SEQA resolution.
Correct. Okay, roll call.
Bonacek?
Yes.
Ekis?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnestakis?
Benton?
Berkman?
Yes.
Cheney?
Yes.
Dillard?
Yes.
Fagio?
Yes.
Heinz?
Yes.
Kemmons?
Yes.
Bullock?
Yes.
Paduk?
Yes.
Riskevich?
Yes.
Sullivan?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Vero?
Yes.
Wong?
Yes.
Gresham?
Yes.
18 ayes, 1 no.
Now the authorizing inclusion of that same district, or same property, rather.
Legislators Ekis, Dillard, Berkman, Kemmons.
Discussion? Roll call.
Bonacek?
Yes.
Ekis?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnestakis?
Benton?
No.
Berkman?
Yes.
Cheney?
Yes.
DeSalvo?
Yes.
Fagio?
Yes.
Heinz?
Yes.
Kemmons?
Yes.
Bullock?
Yes.
Paduk?
Yes.
Riskevich?
Yes.
Sullivan?
Yes.
Turnbull?
Yes.
Vero?
Yes.
Wong?
Yes.
Gresham?
Yes.
18 ayes, 1 no.
Okay, resolution number 10.
Legislators Ekis, Cheney, Bonacek, and Heinz. Resolution of the Orange County Legislature assuming lead agency status, taking the action as a Type 1, and making a determination under the State Environmental Quality Review Act, SEQA, with respect to the proposed amendment and supplement economic development strategy to the Orange County Comprehensive Plan.
Discussion? Roll call.
Bonacek?
Yes.
Ekis?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnestakis?
Benton?
Berkman?
Cheney?
DeSalvo?
Fagio?
Heinz?
Kemmons?
Bullock?
Paduk?
Riskevich?
Sullivan?
Turnbull?
Vero?
Wong? Gresham?
19 ayes.
Resolution number 11.
Legislators Ekis, Cheney, Bonacek, and Heinz. Resolution of the Orange County Legislature adopting an amendment and supplement to the Orange County Comprehensive Master Plan Economic Development Strategy for Orange County pursuant to Section 9.02 of the Orange County Administrative Code.
Second.
Yes, Minority Leader Ekis.
Yes, I'd like to make an amendment to the Orange County Economic Development Strategy. I don't know if my fellow legislators have the booklet in front of them or not, but I will thoroughly describe the amendment I'd like to make. And it is on page 29, about 3/4 of the way down, and it currently states, "With an additional $200,000 added to the Tourism Division's promotional budget, less than 10% of the hotel occupancy tax collected in 2012, Orange County could accomplish the following. My amendment is to take out, with an additional $200,000 added to the Tourism Division's promotional budget, less than 10% of the hotel occupancy tax collected in 2012. So in other words, it will now read, Orange County could accomplish the following, and it goes to list various different things like banner ads, television spots, and so on. I'm looking to take that monetary value out of there. It is the only place in the entire document where we designate an amount to a department, and that's all to be left for the budget season. We will determine when the budget season comes along how much we would like to add. And I think we all read the newspaper and saw what happened, and I think we all have a big question about a simple $5,000 check that was distributed without my knowledge personally, and I don't know who else's, and I'd like to know where that money came from and why that was distributed specifically for tourism. So again, I do not want to give permission for the $200,000. That's what I'm looking to take out of there.
Okay, is there a discussion on the motion? It was discussed in committee. We didn't make the change in committee, but it was discussed. Yeah?
Yeah, I'll be very brief. I'm supporting the amendment. I'll vote for it because I don't want there to be any misunderstanding about the policy. This is a policy document, which is clearly our jurisdiction. And I don't want the executive branch to misinterpret that as authorization, because you have to come back to authorize that $200,000 or $100,000 or $500,000, whatever we decide. But I think it'll clear things up if we stick to the policy and deal with authorization at budget time.
I think we're all supportive of the document, so I don't personally see a problem with this amendment, because it is the only place in the document wherein a dollar figure is mentioned. So it's not going to dilute the plan at all. So, okay, any more discussion on that? Okay, let's go with roll call on Chris's amendment.
Anagnostakis. Yes. Emo. Yes. Anagnostakis. Yes. Benton. Yes. Berkman. Yes. Cheney. DeSalvo. Baggio. Hines. Chemnitz. Kulisek. Paduk. Ruskevich. Sullivan. Turnbull. Biro. Wong. Gresham. 19 ayes.
Good deal. Okay, resolution number 12. Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, that's right. Okay. As amended. Okay.
Anissa?
Yes.
Ekis?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Cheney? DeSalvo? Baggio? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Ruskevich? Sullivan? Turnbull? Vera? Wong? Gresham? 19 ayes.
Okay, resolution 12.
Legislators Cheney and Ekis. Resolution providing for public hearing upon the tentative budget for Orange County Community College for the fiscal year beginning September 1st, 2015, pursuant to section 6304 of the education law.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Anisek?
Yes.
Ekis?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Cheney? DeSalvo? Fagion? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Ruskevich? Sullivan? Turnbull? Bureau, Wong, Gresham, 19 ayes. Date is August 6, 2015 at 3:15 p.m.
Number 13.
Legislators Paduk, Turnbull. Resolution to support Randall Airport's application for New York State Department of Transportation funds under the 2014 Aviation Capital Grant Program.
Second.
Question? Yes, certainly. Roll call.
Anisek?
Yes.
Ekis?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnostakis? Benton? Berkman? Cheney? DeSalvo? Fagion? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Ruskevich? Sullivan? Turnbull? Bureau? Wong? Gresham? 19 ayes.
Number 14.
Legislators Turnbull, Bureau. Resolution of the Orange County Legislature giving notice of intent to assume lead agency status under State Environmental Quality Review Act SEAKER with respect to the construction of Larkin Drive West and making a preliminary determination that this project be classified as a type 1 action.
Second.
Discussion? Yes, Legislator Amo.
Could I have my name added to, Mr. Chairman?
Yes.
This is something I'm so excited about moving forward on. Back when I came into the legislature, we formed the Southeast Orange Traffic Task Force, and among the number of the first things we did was to look at how we extend Larkin Drive to go up to 130, exit 130 on 17. And the simple reason we looked at that question was that if you Googled how to get a private from, you know, Sears to drop a product up someplace, they sent you through the village in the road. They just get that seen the way they got you there. So you just all the traffic going through the village will have the opportunity to run right along the footway and deliver it. It seems like it's a great thing, but it's been years in coming, so I'm glad we're doing it.
And I'd like to thank Commissioner Bybrock for being out ahead doing a shovel ready through. If we do get the money, we'll be ready to go. Okay, roll call. You want to be added? Okay, certainly. Roll call.
Bonacek?
Yes.
Ekis?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnestakis?
No.
Benton? Berkman? Cheney? DeSalvo? Fagione? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Ruskevich? Sullivan? Turnbull? Vero? Wong? Brescia? 18 ayes, 1 no.
Okay, resolution 15.
Legislators Turnbull and Ruskevich. Resolution of the Orange County Legislature assuming lead agency status under the State Environmental Quality Review Act SEQR with respect to the Orange Farm No. 2 bridge replacement, classifying the action as unlisted and determining that the action will not have any significant adverse environmental impacts.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Bonacek?
Yes.
Ekis?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnestakis? Benton? Berkman? Cheney? DeSalvo, Fagione, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, Paduk, Ruskevich, Sullivan, Turnbull, Vero, Wong, Brescia, 19 ayes.
Okay, number 16, also a bond resolution.
Legislators Ruskevich, Vero, Turnbull, and DeSalvo. Amending bond resolution dated July 1st, 2015, bond resolution of the County of Orange, New York, amending the bond resolution adopted October 4th, 2012 in relation to financing the cost of replacement of Orange Farm Bridge No. 2 located in the town of Goshen at the estimated cost of $490,000.
Discussion? Roll. Yes, Chairman. Certainly. Yep. Minority Leader Ekis.
Since we're on bridges, I just want to mention that we have a ceremony tomorrow, finally opening a Forge Hill Road Bridge. So it's at 1 o'clock, so everybody's invited.
I would make it moving south a little bit. Okay, roll call.
Bonacek?
Was there pretty young last year, right?
Bonacek?
Yes.
Ekis?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnestakis? Benton? Berkman? Cheney? DeSalvo, Fagione, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, Paduk, Ruskevich, Sullivan, Turnbull, Vero, Wong, Brescia, 19 ayes.
Okay, number 17.
Legislators Paduk, Turnbull, and DeSalvo. Resolution authorizing the county executive in conjunction with the Orange County Department of Public Works to implement and fund in the first instance 100% of the federal aid and state Marcuselli program aid eligible costs of a transportation federal aid project and appropriate funds therefore, and enter into supplemental agreement number 4 with the New York State Department of Transportation to increase the construction and inspection phase of Scotchtown Avenue Bridge, Crystal Run Bridge, Capital Project 473, pursuant to Section 99-H of the General Municipal Law and Section 4.09 of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Bonacek?
Yes.
Ekis?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnestakis? Benton? Berkman, Cheney, DeSalvo, Fagione, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, Paduk, Ruskevich, Sullivan, Turnbull, Vero, Wong, Brescia, 19 ayes.
Okay, number 18, another bond resolution.
Legislators Turnbull, Paduk, and DeSalvo, amending bond resolution dated July 1st, 2015, further amending the bond resolution adopted December 1st, 2011, and amended March 1st, 2012, and further amended June 5th, 2014, in relation to financing the cost of reconstruction of the Scotchtown Avenue Crystal Run Bridge located in the town of Hamptonburg at the total estimated cost of $6,952,388.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Conneson.
Yes.
Ickes.
Yes.
Amo.
Yes.
Anagnestakis. Benton. Berkman. Cheney. DeSalvo. Fagion. Heinz. Kemnitz. Kulisek. Paduk. Riskevich. Sullivan. Turnbull. Vero. Wong. Gresha. 19 ayes.
Okay, number 19.
Legislators Riskevich, Turnbull, DeSalvo. Bond resolution dated July 1st, 2015. Bond resolution of the County of Orange, New York, authorizing the partial reconstruction of the Department of Public Works garage in the Village of Goshen, stating the estimated maximum cost thereof is $450,000, appropriating $300,000 therefore, in addition to the $150,000 previously appropriated, and authorizing the issuance of $300,000 bonds of the county to finance said appropriation.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Conneson.
Yes.
Ickes.
Yes.
Amo.
Yes.
Anagnestakis.
No.
Benton.
Yes.
Berkman.
No.
Cheney. DeSalvo. Fagion. Heinz. Kemnitz. Kulisek. Paduk. Riskevich. Sullivan. Turnbull. Vero. Wong. Gresha. 17 ayes, 2 noes.
Okay, number 20, another bond resolution.
Legislators Turnbull and Kulisek. Bond resolution dated July 1st, 2015. Bond resolution of the County of Orange, New York, authorizing acquisition and installation of a new computerized HVAC management system for the Orange County Courthouse Building, stated the estimated maximum cost thereof is $400,000, appropriating said amount therefore, and authorizing the issuance of $400,000 bonds of the county to finance said appropriation.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Oh, you want your name out?
Yes. Roseanne. Okay, roll call.
Conneson.
Yes.
Ickes.
Yes.
Amo.
Yes.
Anagnestakis. Benton. Berkman, Cheney, DeSalvo, Fagion, Heinz, Kemnitz, Kulisek, Paduk, Riskevich, Sullivan, Turnbull, Vero, Wong, Gresha. 19 ayes.
21.
Legislators Turnbull, Kulisek, and DeSalvo. Bond resolution dated July 1st, 2015. Bond resolution of the County of Orange, New York, authorizing replacement of fuel tanks at the Orange County Airport, stating the estimated maximum cost thereof is $240,000, appropriating said amount therefore, and authorizing the issuance of $240,000 bonds of the county to finance said appropriation.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Conneson.
Yes.
Ickes.
Yes.
Amo.
Yes.
Anagnestakis. Benton. Berkman. Cheney. DeSalvo. Fagion. Heinz. Kemnitz. Kulisek. Paduk. Riskevich, Sullivan, Turnbull, Vero, Wong, Gresha. 19 ayes.
Okay, number 22.
Mr. Chairman?
Yes.
Can you just remove my name from that?
You're a no vote?
No, I'm a vote. Just said I want my
name. Okay. As a sponsor, you mean? Okay.
Yep.
22.
Legislators Berkman, Kulisek, Paduk, and Turnbull. Resolution authorizing the county executive in conjunction with the Orange County Department of Public Works Airport to accept funds from the New York State Department of Transportation pursuant to Section 99-H of the General Municipal Law and Section 4.09 of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Question. Roll call.
Conneson.
Yes.
Ickes.
Yes.
Amo.
Yes.
Anagnestakis. Benton. Berkman. Cheney. DeSalvo. Fagion. Heinz. Kemnitz, Kulisek, Paduk, Riskevich, Sullivan, Turnbull, Vero, Wong, Gresha. 19 ayes.
Number 23, another bond resolution.
Legislators Bonasek, DeSalvo, and Turnbull. Bond resolution dated July 1st, 2015. Bond resolution of the County of Orange, New York, authorizing parking area improvements at the Orange County Correctional Facility in Goshen, stating the estimated maximum cost thereof is $220,000. Appropriating said amount therefore and authorizing the issuance of $220,000 bonds of the county to finance said appropriation.
Second.
Discussion. Roll call.
Honestly?
Yes.
Ickes?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnestakis?
No.
Benton? Berkman?
No.
Cheney? Dillard? I'm sorry. DeSalvo? Fagion? Heinz? Kemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Riskevich? Sullivan?
No.
Turnbull? Vero? Wong? Gresham? 16 ayes, 3 noes.
Okay, number 24, another bond resolution.
Legislators Bonasek, Vero, DeSalvo, and Kulisek. Bond resolution dated July 1st, 2015. Bond resolution of the County of Orange, New York, authorizing acquisition and installation of load bank equipment for testing electric power generators at the Orange County Correctional Facility in Goshen, stating the estimated maximum cost thereof is $95,000, appropriating said amount therefore, and authorizing the issuance of $95,000 bonds of the county to finance said appropriation.
Second.
Discussion? You want to be added? Tom Pagino? Okay, roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Ekis?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnestakis? Benton? Berkman? Cheney? DeSalvo? Fagion? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Riskevich? Sullivan? Turnbull? Vero? Wong? Gresham? 19 ayes.
Okay, number 25, another bond resolution.
Legislators Bonasek, DeSalvo, and Kulisek. Bond resolution dated July 1st, 2015. Bond resolution of the County of Orange, New York, authorizing acquisition of equipment for the Orange County Correctional Facility in Goshen, stating the estimated maximum cost thereof is $80,000, appropriating said amount therefore, and authorizing the issuance of $80,000 bonds of the county to finance said appropriation.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Ekis?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnestakis?
No.
Benton? Berkman? Cheney, DeSalvo, Fagion, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, Paduk, Riskevich, Sullivan, Turnbull,
no.
Vero, Wong, Gresham, 17 ayes, 2 noes.
Number 26.
Legislators Anagnestakis and DeSalvo. Resolution authorizing the private sale and conveyance of certain county-owned lands acquired by reason of a failure to redeem said lands from a tax sale to Orange County pursuant to section 10184 of the real property tax law in Orange County amended local law number 2 of 2010.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Ekis?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnestakis? Benton? Berkman? Cheney? DeSalvo? Fagion, Hines, Chemnitz, Kulisek, Paduk, Riskevich, Sullivan, Turnbull, Vero, Wong, Gresham, 19 ayes.
Lost my place. We're in 27? Okay, that's what I thought.
Legislator Hines, resolution pursuant to real property tax law, section 558, directing the cancellation of certain taxes which have been rendered unenforceable.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Ekis?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnestakis? Benton? Berkman? Cheney? DeSalvo? Fagion? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Riskevich? Sullivan? Turnbull? Vero? Wong? Gresham? 19 ayes.
Okay, 28.
Legislators Anagnestakis and Wong, resolution authorizing the county executive in conjunction with the Orange County Department of Social Services to accept funds from the New York State Office of Children and Family Services pursuant to section 99-H of General Municipal Law and section 4.09 of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion? Yes. All three? Okay. And Barry also. And Mr. Turnbull. Okay. And Myrna and Jim. Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Ekis?
Yes.
Amo? Amo? Anagnestakis? Benton? Berkman? Cheney? DeSalvo? Fagion? Hines? Chemnitz? Kulisek? Paduk? Riskevich? Sullivan? Turnbull? Vero? Wong? Gresham? 19 ayes.
Okay, number 29.
Legislators Bonasek, Ekis, and Chemnitz. Resolution authorizing the county executive in conjunction with the Orange County Department of Health to appropriate fourth year funds from the New York State Department of Health, Health Research, Inc. pursuant to section 99-H of the General Municipal Law and section 4.09 of the Orange County Charter.
Second.
Discussion? Roll call.
Bonasek?
Yes.
Ekis?
Yes.
Amo?
Yes.
Anagnestakis? Benton? Berkman? Cheney, DeSalvo, Fagion, Hines, Kemnitz, Kulisek, Padoo, Ruskovich, Sullivan, Turnbull, Vero, Wong, Gresham. 19 ayes, Mr. Chairman, and the desk is clear.
Okay, we have one speaker signed up for afterward. Anthony J. Monaco Jr. From Scotchtown Avenue, taxpayer concern. Is Anthony still here? Carrie, need a speaker? Microphone, excuse me. At the speaker, with the microphone.
How you doing? I have a business, a landscaping business. And I'd like to know why does it appear that only commercial vehicles with lettering have to abide by the rules. For example, as small business owner, I am responsible to pay comp insurance, where the commercial, when the non-commercial mowers and landscapers, anything. They don't pay taxes either. I thought that everybody had to pay charge county tax, except only the ones with their name on the trucks. I know the county needs money. I keep saying it in the paper, but a lot of money to the county. I have to abide by the DOT rules and regulations, and routinely get stopped. Commercial vehicle checkpoints and summoned selective. This appears to be selective enforcement in nature and irresponsible. You are encouraged that those of us have constantly do the right thing. The rules. They also pay state, federal, and county tax. And other people don't pay anything. Yeah, I think it's selective enforcement that you, the county, do not go after these people that, you know, do the same thing, the job that we do, charging tax for their labor like we have. I'm late on, I'm going to pay my county taxes, they call me. They don't harass these guys. I would like to see licensing. I've been trying for 3 years to try to talk to different people about this. Nowhere. I'd like to see county taxes, county licensing for landscapers, tree work, black hoppers, excavators, construction, plumbers. I don't have insurance and you don't have comp. I just think it's fair that we should be on a playing, you know, the same playing field as everybody else.
You're just giving a speech right now. We don't have a question and answer here. Billy noted, I think some of what you're talking about is DOT.
No, it's not just DOT. It's all about that. Why certain people have to be charged with certain people.
We'll take your comments under advisement. Thank you, Anthony. I'd like to wish everyone a happy, healthy, and safe 4th of July weekend. Stay safe. Thank you. Motion to adjourn.